Hi, I'm Patrick Schelble. I'm the integration specialist for Navico, and I'm here today with an all-new product called the Simrad Cruise. Now, this happens to be a 9-inch, and we're going to go through the installation process of the new Cruise system. Right now, we're going to look and see what's in the box. First off, we have our all-new Simrad Cruise. We have a transducer. All the essential mounting hardware for the transducer and the unit. And of course, your optional bracket mount, as well as your power cord for the unit. So Simrad Cruise was made to be simple. Now you can see here at the back of the unit, you have two ports, one being transducer, the other being power. Now I'm holding the power cord in my hand now and I can see that it is keyed. That means I can only put it in one direction. And as I press it in, I can feel the O-ring on the back of this power cord seating for a good watertight connection. Transducer is the same way. You have keyed, actually two keys, that press in and make sure that you have a good watertight connection. So now let's look at some of the mounting options. So what we've got here is your typical flush mount install. Now what we've done is we've used our mounting template that came in the box and we've cut out our hole. And you can see here, the 9-inch sits right in. Using the hardware that was supplied in the box, I have four stainless steel Phillips head screws. And what I'll use these for is the four holes in the corner, and I'll use the four caps to cover the holes. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna insert all four of our stainless steel screws and install our corner caps. The other way to mount is by bracket. You can see here the Simrad 5-inch Cruise mounted by its supplied quick release bracket. The advantage of a bracket mount installation is that whenever you leave your boat, you can take a unit with you. To get power to your unit, you'll see that your power cord will split into two ends. You got a black for ground and red for 12 volt. Now you'll also receive in the box an inline fuse. You'll attach this to the red via the butt connectors that were also received. You can see here your fuse, which is a 3-amp, you'll install in the inline fuse. Once you've gotten the wires properly connected, to connect to your power supply, make sure you use the proper connectors recommended by your boat manufacturer. With the transducer supplied in the Cruise box, there are two ways to mount the transducer. Transom mount in the water or in the bilge. Using the proper instructions from Airmar, you can have the correct epoxy and have this transducer mounted in the bilge like so. The downside of mounting in the bilge is you lose water temperature. Upside, you don't drill in the back of your boat. Once you have your power wired to the fuse block and your transducer pulled through the hull, connect the power cable and the transducer cable to the back of the unit like we showed you before, and you are ready to get on the water. A properly installed power cable, transducer, and Simrad Cruise unit, you have everything you need for a day on the water.